everyone, Shannon here. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, we are going to create three cards using the newest Fun Stampers Journeys project kit. I'm also going to share with you three different ways to create some really fun and colorful watercolor backgrounds. We're going to start today's card with three panels that are A2, so they're 4.25 by 5.5, made from Bristol paper. If you've never used Bristol paper before, it is a very smooth paper which will allow your ink to really move and create some really beautiful mixes and transitions. You will also need some water-based ink. Today I'm using these Tombow Dual Brush pens. I have four colors picked out. If you don't have water-based markers, you can also use water-based ink pads. You will just smush the ink pad directly down onto the acrylic block instead of coloring on the acrylic block, which is what I'm doing with these markers. I'm kind of placing these colors down randomly, but I did start with my lightest color first. And I am being a little bit more heavy-handed with my lightest color because that's a color that seems to get eaten up the most by the darker shade, so I have a little bit more of that. Once I get the acrylic block completely covered with my ink, I then am going to grab a spray bottle and I'm going to spray some water over the acrylic block until I get some puddles of water, not too much water that it's kind of running off the edge. I'll hold up the camera here so you can kind of see the size of those puddles. Then I will grab my panel of Bristol paper and I will flip this block over and place it down onto that panel. It is helpful to stand up while you're doing this, that way it's a little bit easier to get that block in the center. Once I got it placed down, I'll then press gently on the top and then I'm going to actually weight this down with something. I used actually just my cup that I was drinking from. Just weight that down on, put a weight on top of that acrylic block and don't move the block or the weight until it's completely dry. We're now going to move on to our second background. I'm going to be using the same four Tombow Dual Brush pen colors that I used earlier, and I'm going to start with that marker direct to paper, kind of holding it at a little bit of an angle, and scribble down some of that marker color on to the paper. I'm basically doing this in wide, broad stripes of color, and I have four colors picked out, so I'm going to finish up this last section here. If you're using ink pads, you can take that ink pad direct to paper and kind of run that ink pad over the top of it and get it kind of this streaky bit of color. The important thing is just to get some the ink down onto the paper. Now with a damp brush, I'm going to take this brush and go over that ink. That's going to activate that ink, get it a little bit runny, and then I'm going to kind of blend it back and forth to help smooth out that transition and also fill in any of those little white spots that I didn't completely cover with the when I was using the marker. I'm going to finish up here with this very last section, kind of this indigo color, again blending it out to kind of create a nice transition. And now that I've finished kind of smoothing that out, I'll hold to the camera and you can see here we have this beautiful ombre, bright, vibrant background, and was very easy to create. Now I'm going to move on to my third and final panel. For this panel, I have a piece of laminated cardstock here. You could use a sheet of acetate if you had that. The laminated cardstock just makes it a little bit easier so you can see the colors and where you're placing them. Again, I'm using the same four Tombow Dual Brush pen colors, and I'm just scribbling some color down here, kind of trying to mimic the look of Northern Lights, but what you'll see when I smush it down, it just kind of blends together and just kind of creates a pretty background. So after I placed down my four colors, I then spritzed it with water, and then I'm going to take my Bristol paper and place it on top. Now again, if you are using ink pads, you would just smush the ink pads down onto your laminated cardstock or your sheet of acetate. So after I smushed it down, I'm then going to pick it up here so you can see it's still wet, and then I'm going to take a paintbrush and I'm going to kind of move that ink around and kind of paint in some of those areas that didn't get completely covered with that watered down ink. I'm also going to use this brush to pick up the excess watered down ink, which you can see there at the very top, there's a little ribbon of that. So I've dried my brush a little bit here and I'm just using it to kind of absorb some of that watered down, that excess watered down ink. And once I get that kind of finished, all the extra ink absorbed and all my little white spots kind of covered, I'm going to set this aside to dry. So now all my three panels are dry. I'm going to go ahead and remove my cup that was waiting, holding down that acrylic block. And then I will remove that acrylic block to reveal that first panel that we created. So we get this cool kind of background from that. Really love how that turned out. And now I'm going to create our images for these cards. So here is one of the stamp sets included in the project kit. I am going to use a lot of images from this set. I am going to stamp all my images for my three cards all at once. So I'm going to pull off several polar bears, including the igloo as well as the iceberg. And I'm going to position them here onto another panel of Bristol paper. That's because I'm going to watercolor these images in. And I'm going to stamp them in black licorice ink. And this ink is waterproof, which is awesome, and it will work really well for when we watercolor these in. So I'm just going to stamp them here in the black licorice, and once I've done stamp them, I'm going to let them dry a bit, and then I'll be ready to watercolor them. I'm going to do some really, really simple watercoloring with these images. Again, I'm going to use some Tombow Dual Brush pens. The colors I'm using are on screen. For these polar bears, I'm only going to use one marker. That's it, a gray. So I kind of colored in anywhere that's going to be kind of darker. So kind of his backside, his leg that's in the back will be in shadow. Any place that would be kind of in shadow, I color with the marker directly. And after I color it in, I'll then take a brush, get a little bit of water on it, and just kind of blend it out, just kind of soften those streaks and get kind of a nice gradation. So super simple. If you are using ink pads, you would just smush the ink pad down onto your acetate or your laminated paper and then use the color, the ink from there, just kind of water it down a little bit to use that to kind of color your images. So for the igloo, I'm using the marker direct to paper. Here I'm kind of using this really pretty pool color. I'm going around each of the ice blocks in the igloo. Once I finish with my marker, I'll then again grab my damp brush here and just kind of soften wherever I colored with that ink a little bit, just kind of remove a little bit of the streakiness from the marker and also kind of create a little gradation, just kind of makes it look a little bit more realistic. And once I finish kind of coloring or smoothing that out, rather, I am going to move on to the iceberg. The iceberg is pretty much the same way, using the exact same marker that I used earlier. Just going to color at the very base of it, then blend it out so I have a little gradation. And then I'll go back with my marker and just kind of color in these other areas just to make them a little bit darker and a little bit more interesting. Now that I finished coloring all my images, I'm going to actually stamp one more image. I'm going to grab this star here from that same set, and I'm just going to position it in the little negative space here on this Bristol paper. This could have been just stamped on whipped cream paper, but I am going to just use it on the same paper, and I stamped it in Cool Pool ink. Now I'm going to die cut all of my images out with the matching dies, including that little star. The igloo and the iceberg don't have dies, so I am going to fussy cut those out. So I just grabbed a pair of scissors, and it's really easy to kind of fussy cut these out. I am going to cut a little border, just kind of mimic that border that, or that size of that border that the die created on the polar bears and the star. Now that all of my images are done, I'm ready to kind of bring some of these cards together. I'm going to start with this background here. I did trim it down, so now it is 4 by 5 1/4. So I basically just trimmed 1/8 inch off all four sides. I'm going to add some tape to the backside and then adhere it onto an A2 top folding white card base. Once I've got that stuck down, I'm going to move on to my sentiment. I do have some of my images arranged here just so I can figure out where my sentiment's going to go. I'll then pick it up with my Misty, and then I'm going to put some anti-static powder down because I'm going to do some heat embossing. I'm going to ink up my stamp in an embossing ink, and then I'll fold my Misty over here and then just stamp it. I'll then dip my card into some white embossing powder, just tap off the excess, and then I will heat set this with my heat tool. Now all I have to do to finish up this card is to adhere my images. I did add some foam tape to the back side of them to give them a little bit of dimension, so I'll just remove the backing on the foam tape and then stick them down. Started with the iceberg, then I'm going to move on to my two polar bears, and after I stick those guys down, the last thing I have to stick down is this star, kind of give them something to look up at, and that will finish that card. I'll hold up to the camera here so you can get a quick look at the background with our images. Really kind of sweet card. I'm now going to move on to my second card here. I'm first just going to adhere this down to an A2 top folding white card base. I didn't trim this panel down at all, so it's going to cover the whole card front. Now that I have that stuck down, I'm going to move on to stamping my sentiment. This sentiment is also from the same set with the polar bears. Again, I'm going to ink it up with some black licorice ink and just stamp it in the upper right corner of my card front. With my sentiment stamped, I'm ready to kind of bring it together. I have a strip here of whipped cream cardstock that I trimmed down to be 3/4. across by 5.5. I'm just going to add some liquid glue to the backside and then adhere it right on to my card front. I also went ahead and added some foam tape to the backside of my polar bears. I'm just going to remove the backing here on each one of these and then stick them down, and that will actually complete that card. So another really sweet, pretty, beautiful background card. Now we're going to finish up our third and final card. I did trim this panel down so it is 3 3/4 by 5 inches. I just cut basically 1/4 inch off all four sides. And now I'm going to adhere it with a tape runner down to the front of an A2 white card base. So once I have that panel stuck down, I'm ready to move on to my sentiment. I'm going to grab this sentiment right here from the same set with the polar bears, and I'm going to curve it. So I'm going to start by just getting the tail end of the sentiment positioned, and then I'm going to start to manipulate and bend this, always sticking it back to my Misty here to get it into the, to kind of hold it in place. And I'm trying to get this curve to match the curve of the igloo. So I'm going back and forth until I get it just right. Now that I have the sentiment curved, I'm going to ink it up in black licorice ink and stamp this. You could also do this on an acrylic block. I just trust myself a little bit better with the Misty. Now that I've stamped my sentiment, I'm going to grab these two sets from the kit, and I'm going to grab a snowflake from each one of these sets, mount them onto two acrylic blocks, and I'm going to do some heat embossing. I did cover this panel with some anti-static powder, and I'm now going to ink up these snowflakes in some embossing ink. So I'm just going to ink them up and then stamp them onto the front of my card, only basically stamping them onto the watercolored background. So after I stamped one large snowflake, I'm now going to move on to a smaller one, and I'm just going to go back and forth and repeatedly stamp these till this panel is mostly covered with these snowflakes. I am avoiding the area just below my sentiment and definitely not going to stamp on my sentiment. So I'm going to continue this until most of this panel is covered with these snowflakes. So now that I'm done stamping, I'm going to dip my card into white embossing powder, tap off the excess. After I've tapped off the excess, I did notice I had a little bit stuck to my sentiment. So I'm just going to grab a paintbrush here and just kind of brush that white embossing powder off of my sentiment. And then I will heat set these snowflakes with my heat tool. And after I've heat set that, I'm ready to kind of wrap this final card up. I did trim down some more whipped cream cardstock down to create a strip that is 3/4 by 4 1/4. And I've added some foam tape, not only to the strip of cardstock, but also to the backside of my igloo. But I am going to double up the foam tape at the very top of the igloo just to kind of support it. So I'm going to first stick down that white strip of cardstock, then I'll stick down my igloo here. And once I get that stuck down, this card is complete. And I'll hold this card up to the camera so you can get a good look at all the details in this card. Really love how this turned out. Lots of dimension. Really love that simple ombre watercolor background. I think the really bold color looks beautiful with those heat embossed snowflakes. They really stand out, all the details in them, and I love that curve sentiment. Here is the second card we created. This one's a very kind of clean and simple one. I really love it. I think it pairs well with that kind of peaceful sentiment. And then we're going to finish up here with this final one that we created with the acrylic block. Another really easy watercolor background that I think works really well with these images and the sentiment. I hope you guys enjoyed today's cards and video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.